Good morning, my dear students. Welcome for the online classes. Today we are going to start with the geography lesson number 1, India size and location. Children, in the earlier classes, you have studied about our country India and also you have studied about the size and location. But today again we are going to study about India's size and location in detail. India, children, India is one of the oldest civilization. The people of Indus Valley civilization practiced town planning that would be any of even the most modern cities of the world. India is inhabited by the people with a wide variety of languages, subcultures and religions. Within this diversity runs a common thread of unity. Children, the countries comprising the Indian subcontinent include Pakistan, Bangladesh, Nepal and Bhutan. Now neighboring countries separated by the Indian Ocean are Sri Lanka and Maldives. Now children, we are going to study about the location of the India. Now, India is a vast country lying entirely in the northern hemisphere. Now, children, you know that the earth is divided into two parts, northern hemisphere and southern hemisphere. This line which you will see, this dotted line, it is nothing but the equator which divides the earth into two halves. That is, the part of the earth which lies above the equator is the northern hemisphere and the part of the earth which lies to the south of the earth is the southern hemisphere. Now children, can you see our India? This is our country India. Now our country India lies totally in the northern hemisphere. Okay, and the Tropic of the Cancer passes exactly between the middle of the country. Now the places situated on or near the Tropic of Cancer have the noon sun exactly overhead twice a year. Now children, again see, can you see one dotted line here? This is again, it is the 0 degree. Now this is the prime meridian. Now this prime meridian divides the earth into two equal parts, that is eastern hemisphere and western hemisphere. Now the part of the earth which lies towards the east of the earth is the eastern hemisphere and the part of the earth which lies towards the west of the earth is the western hemisphere. Now can you see our India? It is completely in the eastern hemisphere. Now the western extreme is marked by the longitude 87.7 degree east, means eastern hemisphere, and 97.25 east. Now children, here the distance between the extreme longitude east to west is 2,933 kilometers. Now this is about the location. Now children, so the location of our India is clear, that our India is located in the northern hemisphere and in the eastern hemisphere. Now the Arabian Sea, now our India is bounded by the three oceans, Indian Ocean, Arabian Sea and Bay of Bengal. Arabian Sea touches Gujarat, Daman and Diu, Maharashtra, Goa, Karnataka, Kerala and Tamil Nadu, and Lakshadweep Islands are situated in the Arabian Sea. This group of islands is situated in the Arabian Sea. And the states and the union territories situated in the Bay of Bengal includes West Bengal, Orissa, Andhra Pradesh, Pondicherry, Tamil Nadu and Andaman and Nicobar Islands. Now children, the Kanyakumari is said to be situated on the Bay of Bengal, Arabian Sea and Indian Ocean. Now it is the place on the mainland India nearest to equator. Now children, the duration of day and night are almost equal here. It would not be so at the places in the north that are situated farther from the equator. So children, this is about the location of our India. Now let us study about the size of India. Now children, when we talk about the size of India, the landmass of India has an area of 3.28 million square kilometer. So the total area of our India is 3.28 million square kilometer, and India's total area accounts for about 2.4% of the total geographic area of the world. India is the 7th largest country of the world. India has a land boundary of about 15,200 kilometers, and the length of the coastline of the mainland, including Andaman and Nicobar Island, is 7,516.6 kilometers. Now children, it is the seventh, as we say, India is the seventh largest country in the world, and also India with the great Himalayas in the north stretches southward, and at the Tropic of Cancer tapers off in the Indian Ocean. Now just look at figure 1.3 and note that the latitudinal and the longitudinal extent of the main land is about 30 degrees. Now despite this fact, the east-west extent appears to be the smaller than the north-south extent. Now children, you can see from Gujarat to Arunachal Pradesh, there is a long time lag of 2 hours. Now, the latitudinal extent influences the day and the night as one moves from south to north. In the earlier classes, children, you have studied why we have the difference in the time between the two places in the same country. So that is because of the latitudinal and the longitudinal extent. So today we have studied about the size and the location of India. Read the points which are given in the textbook thoroughly and try to understand the concept. Thank you. In the next period, we will continue with another topic. Thank you.